The fact of the matter is that cybersecurity incidents are growing exponentially, and the consequences are costly. In terms of the effects of incidents over the last several years, they've included the theft of credit and debit card accounts through retailers like Target and Home Depot. Other incidents have included the exposure of sensitive information on hundreds of millions of individuals who kept information at banks like JP Morgan Chase, health insurers like Anthem and Premera Blue Cross, and government agencies like the U.S. Office of Personnel Management. Information stolen ranges from street and email addresses to medical identification and social security numbers to fingerprints and detailed biographical data. One international crime syndicate allegedly used information stolen from these and other intrusions to manipulate the price of U.S. stocks. We've also seen cyber attacks destroy company systems and wipe out data, such as at Sony Pictures. We've seen money stolen from the Bank of Bangladesh, and we've seen power blackouts triggered through digital means, which last year plunged just under 250,000 Ukrainians into darkness. But as serious as these incidents are individually and collectively, none effectively illustrates the potential catastrophic consequences that cyber incidents can have when they transcend individual institutions and affect our markets and financial systems. This is what we focused on at the U.S. Treasury Department, the effects of cyber attacks on markets and financial systems. So for a glimpse of this type of risk, I'll turn to Mr. Robot, which is a popular U.S. television series. So for those of you who haven't seen the show, Mr. Robot portrays a group of hacktivists operating out of a funhouse in Coney Island, New York. And at the end of the first season, the hacktivists have carried out a massive attack against a large multinational corporation called E-Corp. E-Corp dominates commercial banking worldwide. Through a variety of tactics and techniques, from manipulating employees through social engineering to deploying a zero-day exploit, the hackers break through E-Corp's cyber defenses, they encrypt all the company's data, and they destroy separately stored backup copies of the data. The goal of this destructive attack is to wipe out $400 billion of debt owed to E-Corp. Everything from student loans to mortgages. The next day, the global financial system freezes, stock markets plunge, credit card networks halt, ATM withdrawals are capped. Well, you say, surely this can't happen. This is Hollywood, not something based on reality. But I ask you, are scenarios in which the financial system's plumbing gets clogged or breaks down implausible? Haven't we seen this breakdown of financial transmission before? After all, what did the financial crisis teach us about the transmission of contagion? It taught us, among other things, that when the financial system shuts down, liquidity is lost. That illiquidity brings losses to counterparties, which brings losses to the counterparties of the counterparties, and that these losses create losses of confidence, and that when confidence is lost, it's hard to revive.